48 seconds and counting.
Disturb unstable.
Ready to disengage from platform.
Mark, 20 seconds. 18, 17, 16, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Disengage.
Umbilicus clear.
Money's safe. Let's take her down.
Roll 92 degrees, port yaw.
Prime the port.
Hey, Kid Factory fans, well, welcome to the spring something update. I'm not sure. Today we're going to take a look a little bit at weathering technique. On top of the fact that I have a really, really cool segment in this video about Michael King, who runs this website, and here's his email, and this guy makes really unique and unusual t-shirts. Not this one, because I haven't opened the box yet, so we'll show you all that. And it's a box that must weigh 50 pounds, so I thought Mike would send me a few t-shirts. Apparently he sent me a few hundred, but we'll see. But pretty amazing. Thank you, Michael King, for that. He runs a business, and I will talk about all that. And he's been a friend of mine on Facebook for years, and a really good guy. He's got the greatest little dog I've ever seen. Very cute. So we're going to start off with this, which is the Nostromo that's going to be in a big-time library down here in Ormond Beach exhibit. I still haven't done all the detailing towards the rear section. And we will show you a little bit of technique. I've got my pastels here, some of my Tamiya weathering paste. And some of you might find this useful for your modeling needs. And then I've got a tiny Star Destroyer I've been working on, which is to augment the big Super Star Destroyer, which is a big display over 30 inches long with full lighting and battle stations firing and the whole bit. And as I said, in the shots on Star Wars, their Star Destroyers are pretty small compared to the Super Star Destroyer, which must be 3 to 5 miles long. And an interesting augment. I even have a solid cast resin one, which will be unlit because of the nightmare involved in lighting a solid cast resin piece. It can be done, but I'm not willing to go through that hell. Not today. And that one will be going down with some, you know, smoke effect, and be one of the ones that has been destroyed. So it'll be a more interesting display, even though it really doesn't need it. I just thought it'd be fun to add this stuff. So that'll be the two I talk about. Not sure what's coming next. I've been considering the power loader from Aliens. Aliens. Or, again, not quite sure. Maybe it's time for a Voyager again. I haven't built one in a very long time. And, or, I was thinking, that Enterprise C that was destroyed on a way to the client from UPS, which did a terrible job. And I wish I had used a wooden case, which I use most of the time. But this thing was so light and small, I thought double packing it in a very sturdy box set would do it. And somehow they managed to destroy it. And I feel somewhat be-owings to this person. And I'm wondering, would it be something I could take the time to do again? Although, my God, it's a difficult build. And send it to him. Because I never did feel right about that. And I'm wondering, now that I have the time and I have a kit, could I possibly complete one and send it to him? I feel like this man just didn't get a break. And I didn't get a break. One, my fault, UPS. And UPS was a nightmare to get some kind of compensation from, which I sent to him. But we'll see. So that's kind of my plans for the coming year, or the summer. And so now I'll go on with a little demo here for weathering. I'll show you the little project I'm working on, which is just a little augment to an existing project.
Hey, Papa Smurf, you asked for me? What?
Trek. Yes, Trek. Listen, we don't know what happened to the professor. You know, the drones have been missing, and, well, you're up. By the way, what happened to your last little adventure? Did that ever end?
Director Smurf lost the whole script, and, well...
Happens. You know, okay, well, couldn't do anything. I got something for you. These are access under the professor's lab, about level 4 or slightly below. You know, the catacombs? Yeah, well, no, there's nothing down there. Well, not much. Some of the security cameras went down, and we need somebody to go rewire the thing, at least run a lead all the way to the back end under north side of the level 4 and reinstall the camera down there. And you're the only one I got, bud. Sarge is whereabouts unknown. The professor is who knows where. And everybody else seems to be too busy. And the old coot, he isn't getting let out of the funny farm anytime soon. So, yeah, I'm going to need you to do this. We're going to give you a handy-dandy flashlight. Very, very nice night. Okay, don't use that, Sonny. And then you're going to have to wear the camera so I can guide you through the catacombs, or else, well, you never get out of there. No. And we'll take it from there. So what do you say, big guy?
Okay. Uh-huh. Well, there's, like, really, really nasty things down there. You know, he's done a lot of stuff.
Oh, no, those are just stories.
Get me out of here. This bloody thing never works.
Hey, yes, are you paying attention here?
Uh-huh. And that stuff. And, yes, I see. Is this an optional?
No.
I didn't think so. Yeah, well, it's a little creepy down there. Is this supposed to help? Yeah, this thing.
Yeah, you'll love it. Too hot out here. It's nice and
defensive
cool.
Weaponry?
It's really,
you
know,
you're going to
really
get cool. Needed there with this, huh? Oh. Okay, and the little flashlight. Okay, yeah, I won't use that setting. Okay, I gotcha. When do you want to do this?
Well, I was thinking now, bud. Let's get on.
No, not right now. Really? God. All right, where's the access door?
Access door is behind that storage.
Oh, God. Okay. No Smurfs around either, huh?
What? Smurfs are too scared to go down. They don't want anywhere near the professor's lab, you know that.
Yeah, I know how they feel. Okay, Papa Smurf. I'll do my best. Crap.
Oh, boy. Alright, this is level almost 5. Holy crap. Alright, here we go. Oh, boy.
Hey, as a nifty little extra, Michael King is a guy I've known for many years on Facebook as a Facebook friend, and he does some terrific t-shirts, and I've been wanting some for a while, and he sent me a whole lot of t-shirts, and I promised I'd mention them because some of the graphics on there are terrific. I know he does a lot of them, if not all of them, and I had to show it. Now my wife put this on here. It's a gift. And it is. So I'll put that over here. And I haven't opened it yet, even though I'm very excited to take a look at it. Because I did promise it would be a box opening. And this is a real box opening when you haven't done it yet. So with my trusty little X-Acto knife, and without cutting a t-shirt underneath, you're going to see that these designs are something else. Now here's this website, one of them I gather. On Etsy, it's called Hidden Emperor X, and it's pretty interesting. And some of those designs, I've never seen anything like some of them. There's a War of the World ones that I was really blown away by. So I started talking to him, I don't know, last year about it, and we finally worked it out. And they're very unique, per se. Let's see, if I scroll up a bit. You can see, I mean, that's wild. That is just wild. I love the cat. Bella Rogers, the 25th century alien. Looks like a Soviet robot called Clank. I mean, he's got tons of this stuff. It's great. So I will show you the shirts. Let's move this back a bit here. Wow. You said there was quite a lot of them. And there is. Wow. All right. A whole bunch of stickers, which I gather are the graphics on the shirts. Neato. We love stickers here. Oh, coffee cup even. Gosh, I can always use one because I constantly break mine. There we go. Neat. All right, first shirt. It's the one I just mentioned. Cool. The Clank robot. Neat. Now, again, I doubt I'll ever see something like this out on the street. I sincerely doubt it. Let me see here. Authentic. Oh my. Yeah, let me stand over here. This will come a lot better for me. And the lighting is odd here. This is the other end of the studio where I had enough room to do this. Authentic. What is that? what? Oh, it's in Russian, I believe. Or maybe you're seeing it. Oh, I know the graphic's way cool. All right, let's see here. What else? Jeepers. I mean, there's a lot of stuff in there. My God. Whoa, that's tripping. Harry Houdini and the Great World War. Wow, I do not know. This might be something historical. Interview Art Horse Studio. Wow. Oh, my God. I know who's getting this. I know who's getting this. This almost looks like something I should give to Tim Nolan. Because that is interesting. That's right up his alley, too. Let's see. What else we got? Oh, another. I wonder if this Clank thing is a series. Yeah, it certainly looks like Clank is some kind of series. Here's another one. Way cool. And you got them all in my size, which I really appreciate. Except that last one. I think my wife might like that one, too. Let me see here. What is... Oh, excellent. This is one I really wanted. Evil Disney. Illuminati. This. Look at the three-eyed little bastard. Far out, man. I dig this one. This is one of the ones I really liked from way back when I saw his stuff. Let's see. What is it? Oh, the Martian Chronicles. I believe that's, what is that? Teddy Roosevelt? Huh? Wow. And the quality is really nice, too. These are not those cheapo vinyl ones. This is woven right in. My God, I'm running out of room. Oh. What, a repeating pattern? Oh, yeah, I dig it. You, very Matrix in a way. You are here in the cogs of the machine. Far out, man. Oh, holy jeepers. There's a lot of these. My God. Oh. He said to me, he says, you'll never buy another t-shirt again. I think he's right. Now I gotta build shelves or something. I'd say, oh, definitely something my wife would like. She made a painting very similar to this, like a koi fish. Neat. And they're very good quality, too. The fabric on them is real nice. Let's see. Godzilla. Perfect. Something is hot. I don't know. Reading is hot. I don't know. Yeah, reading is hot, yes. Oh. It's very current for baby boomers, I gather. It's way cool. Oh boy, a fluorescent shirt. STFU. Yeah, okay. I guess you go somewhere where you don't like. Yeah, that's a message. Ooh, again, something for the wife, I gather. what is this? L-O-L. L-O-L. LOL, I gather. Oh, laughing out loud. If any of you don't know that one now. Oh my God, we're going to be here for years. Let me see here. Ooh, this is kind of interesting. Oh, and it's got a bit of the Punisher skull look there, which, of course, you know, Elliot Brown, who we just did a film with, was heavily involved with the Punisher cartoon comics. Mr. Marvel himself. Let me see. Oh, OMG, it's VF. Oh, my God, I can't even make it out yet. F-O. People will be staring at you for half an hour trying to figure it out. Yeah. Here's another one. These Clank claws, but in gold on a sort of an off black shirt, which looks really rich. Thank you, Mike. This is freaking great. I'm here to pick up chicks. Check this out. Oh, my God. That's excellent. Oh, my God. Let me see here. I never sparkle. Bella Lugosi, Children of the Night. I mean, the graphics are just great. The captions are not bad either. Oh, here's his Halloween line. He does have some Halloween stuff that's really scary. Here's one of them. Pumpkin death. Oh, my God. We're almost halfway there. Let's see. Oh, nice one. Pumpkin King. No, not Pumpkin Head. Pumpkin King. Oh, wow. Check this out. Oh, that is awesome. That is just crazy. Check this out. One of the old UFO styles in a tie-dye style. Yeah, it's actually tie-dye by here. Wow. That's cool. Holy jeepers. Wow. Oh, man. Alien gray in a gray t-shirt. Brilliant. What a gift. I mean, a couple t-shirts would have been great. I wasn't expecting this. Wow. Oh, my. This looks like one of those 50s or 60s issues cartoon aliens. Neat. Wow. Can't believe how many sent. We're going to have to take an intermission here because I can't stand that long. Oh, neat. I don't even know where this is from. This looks like maybe Japanese anime or something kitsch. I don't know. Wow, that's trippy. It's almost alien-esque, I gather. Yeah. Nice quality shirts, too. I love these. Wow. Well, this stuff just goes on and on. All right, I'm going to take a break here because I'm tired. And there's about 50% more to go. Thanks, Mike. Awesome. All right. I had to sit down because there's so many of these. Standing for a guy with one leg is a difficult thing. Let's see. Oh, I like this. Ancient Alien. Yes, I would qualify, definitely. Cool. Oh, here's the one. This is the first one that caught my eye, and I think I mentioned it. Oh, yeah, this is far out, man. Forgive the jargon, but the War of the Worlds one. I thought this was brilliant. Absolutely brilliant. More based on the old version than the TV one, which had the ships, which, as great as they were, they never got into the tripods. Halloween Town. Again, he's got quite a lot of the Halloween themed shirts. And it is my favorite holiday, so I'll be sure to wear one on Halloween. I just had to go through this with you. I promised him a box opening. It's more of a goof, I guess. Have you been Illuminati with a three-eyed Santa? I hope he hasn't seen my video where Manfred finds him dead on the floor. Yes. Another famous classics. Moonshot. I do like that. Different. So they're very different. I have not seen a t-shirt maker make these kinds of illustrations. Ooh, Alien. The Grays. you don't know about the grays. Maybe it's better. Let's see here. Wow. What is... Whoa. My wife made an octopus painting just like this. And it's at the bottom. You're an aquarium, dude. You're an aquarium. Oh, I like these too. This Soviet style thing is still very hip, and it started around the 80s. This has metallic highlights and all that. Check that out. That's different. Definitely a keeper for me. I'll have to buy a whole new chest of drawers now. Haunters Association. How the Northwest gets haunted. Well, I lived in Seattle for about a year, so I can relate. Although I wouldn't want to live there now. It's a little different. I believe Michael's in Oregon, so I don't know how it's going there, but all the big cities up north are really, really getting there. Resist, rebel, repeat. I suppose whatever side you're on, that applies. Wow. Well, we're sort of getting there. Let's see. This is very metropolis. Yeah. Let's see. 1991 to 2016. Bone mill, 25 years. I believe that's also one of his sites. Below, as I'm showing these, I will be showing the sites he supplied to me. There's two or three of them, and they're all places. For instance, that's his Etsy store. Oh, wow. Alien Green, and guess what? I believe Michael may have been visited one night, like some of us have been. Never know. All right, we're down to the last four here, I think. Wow, I've lost count. Which one is this? Oh yeah, this. Who was that guy back in the 50s that claimed he had been in contact? This is the UFO that he always mentioned. Somebody also said it was the lid for a German vacuum cleaner or something like that. I don't know the validity of all that, but it is interesting. And a blue, almost tie-dye version. Yes, tie-dye version of that image. And I'm into UFOs, so it's a shame Elliot's not here. I'd let him have one. And two more. And then I gotta close. This is not an ad. It's just something fun I thought you'd like. Little mouse-type alien. Yeah, sci-fi is a theme here, isn't it? And let me see. What is it? I love it. You know that X-Files one, I Want to Believe? And it's just very fitting. I can relate. I want to leave. Heck yeah. Well, anyway, so I posted all the links below. And I'll ask him before I do this editing if it's okay to put his email on there, although I'm sure it's on his website. And I hope you enjoyed that. These are great shirts. I love it, and I'm overserved. Thank you, Michael. You know, he took a while to get them out to me because he's a busy guy. He's got to make a living. And he kind of compensated by sending me the entire line. So, all right, so that's our little extra today. I hope you enjoyed that. Moving on. Okay, one last little ditty. This is the tiny little Star Destroyer I'm working on. We're talking really small here. This is the illumination so far. We've got our big time engines in the back doing a little bit of flicker. We've got the start of the illumination system, which is for these clear sections I've added, rather than the original solid walls, which I believe are right here. These are the original solid walls. Now, what'll happen is once I've got lighting probably one, two more projecting forward to hit the rest of this bar here. We'll have a little bit of illumination down the sides, and then you paint over all that. And with a razor knife, you can cut out very small notches that appear to be like windows. The top section, which is that top deck, will be similar in nature. However, I will drill a whole lot of holes on this one, and with a micro vise, and with an LED in the center, without a whole lot of fiber optic nonsense, I should be able, or at least one on each side, I should be able to get a decent light projection from that. This is for that Star Destroyer I was talking about, and it is a little extra. Now over here on that dock underneath, where they captured that rebel ship, there is an aperture here for a fiber optic, which will project a small spotlight up here. So it's the trick is in just how doing it and stuffing in this tiny little thing, which is also very shallow, and giving at least the main details of this thing, and ending up with something somewhat realistic. And as you can see right now, I don't have it all configured correctly or anything, but you can see what I mean. And it's all been modified heavily. A lot of things have been cut away to, fit. And there'll probably be some tweaking along the line. It's possible. It can be done. It's a heck of a challenge because these tiny little things are pretty much to the edge of my vision. Now, here's that solid one, which is slightly bigger than that one is, which I wanted to use, but... However, slicing and dicing into one of these to light it up is a total nightmare and frankly not worth it. But what I want to do is this one will be forward and it'll be banking and it'll be one of the ones that has been knocked out of the fight because the Super Star Destroyer is firing its guns and all that. So it's in the middle of a firefight. I mean, another cool thing would be have tiny little X-Wings, which I have, coming into attack. So, you never know. This could turn into a great big war diorama. But this guy here will definitely be a kill. And this guy here will be still next to it all lit up. So that's where I'm going with this display. So that's where we're at. I hope you enjoyed the video. And have a great week.
Yes, definitely a Matrix.
Oh, Christ. He's got security cameras everywhere, this guy. Anyways, new Matrix in the backyard. You know about the Matrixes, right? Well, if you don't go watch some older films, I can't explain everything. But they're these portals of different universes. So, I've developed the Manfred 5. It is a monstrous tank, completely modern design. It's kind of based on an old German tank and a really irritated turtle. Yes, because it's got all kinds of guns and all kinds of fun stuff. So, what we're going to do, I'm going to have Fritz drive the tank. Okay, here's the story. Otto and all those guys beforehand, my brothers and cousins, well, they've all sort of been hurt badly or dead from some of my escapades back then. But Fritz has never been exposed. Well, I shouldn't say that. Fritz has probably been exposed to a lot of bad things. His mother dropped him on his head. Yeah, and I know, so did I. There's something about the mothers that drop the babies on the head on that side of the family. I don't know what it is. They all have slightly flattened heads, and Fritz is not the brightest hamster in the cage, okay? So, we'll do our best with him. But, it should be interesting. Every time I go into one of these places, it's different, it's new, and sometimes it tries to kill you. Well, good luck this time, boys. And perhaps we'll find a Smurf village to annihilate. Now, that would be nice, now, wouldn't it? Eh, never can tell. So, we're going to get out there and, hopefully, come back. Because that's always debatable with these Matrix thingies. I don't know how Doctor Who did it, because he survived like hundreds of them, and I just don't get it. So, let us proceed outside. You get to look at the Manfred. It's a monster. And then we shall report on our findings. Yes, yes, yes. Back in the old days, we would have to stop it. Well, Fritz, advance. That. Ah, oh, bloody hell, it's those machine things again. You know, interesting fact is that some people theorize that we came along to develop the machines because the machines are the only thing that could travel through space. Interesting, yes? Yes, yes, I think so. Okay, they're shooting! Franz, open up the beacon! Wait a minute. Ooh, that's a big one. Franz, turn this thing around. You know, exploring is so much fun. We'll see you later, boys and girls. Thank you.